It takes the city from a pile of artifacts and stones and really turns it into something that the public can visualize.
Archaeologist Peter Campbell says the scale of the destruction in Syria is unprecedented.
As far as how much we've lost, it's anybody's guess. Entire chapters of history are gone forever. Lives have been lost a second time. The scale has not been seen before. There's been widespread looting and conflict in other countries and in other periods, but this appears to be as thorough as there is.
Maritime archaeology is the study of human movement and exploitation of resources. It's the story of where we came from and where we're going. We often think of divers working on a shipwreck, but maritime archaeology uses a wide range of methods, everything from measuring tapes to 3D modeling, from dendrochronology to mass spectrometry. When you have the potential to find a cannon one day and an intact human brain the next, you have to apply all the possible methods available in science. Think about the artifacts you may find on a shipwreck and how you can interrogate them using science.
Peter, how goes it? Find any ancient artifacts yet today?
Hello, Philippe. We actually came across another 23 shipwrecks in the Fourni Archipelago in July 2016.
The deepest shipwrecks. The ocean is like a huge underwater museum that constantly adds to our knowledge about humanity. With only a fraction of it explored, discoveries are sure to continue long into the future.
Dive down and you follow the cliff down and you're searching, and there's this moment where you just see rocks, and then all of a sudden your eye shifts and you realize, hold on, that's not a rock, that's an ancient pot or that's an ancient anchor. We found 22 ancient shipwrecks in just 13 days. It was absolutely incredible. There were so many ships that we actually had to actively stop searching in order to properly record all of the shipwrecks that we had already found.